In this video, I'll demonstrate how to create a new building and then add floors and sections to it in Microsoft Places. Before you get started, make sure you've met the prerequisites that aka.ms/places requirements describes. Then, use the Connect Microsoft Places commandlet to connect to Places. And use the Set Places Settings commandlet to turn on Buildings and Places Finder. The first step is to create a building. To do that, use the New Place commandlet. You'll set type to building and provide a name and address at a minimum. You could also configure other metadata here, like wheelchair accessibility. Once you've created the building, use the getPlaceV3 commandlet to grab the place ID. Doing so will save you a lot of typing later. The second step is to add floors to the building. Use the new place commandlet again, but set type to floor this time. The name should be a numerical value only, and use the place ID of the building you created earlier as the parent ID. Like before, use the getPlaceV3 commandlet to grab the place ID of the new floor. You'll use this later when setting up sections. After adding the remaining floors, the third step is to add sections. Partition each floor in a way that makes sense. In this case, I'm creating a north and a south section for each floor of my building by using the new place commandlet with type set to section. Last, add resources to the building by using the setPlaceV3 commandlet. This commandlet is a workhorse for configuring all entities in Places. You now have a building configured in Places. The next big step is to configure bookable resources. To do that, we encourage you to watch the next video in this series at aka.ms/configureplacesvideo.